Additionally, you can change the sword order of the cut. The automatic sort option allows you to choose a sort strategy for both by part and in part sorting. Here you can find a new sorting strategy that will aid with heat dissipation. This is especially useful on thicker plates to prevent warping and achieve a more reliable cut. The sort orientation and start position can be configured, as well as setting a smaller figure price strategy in order to prevent cutting on free parts. The common line sorting order can be adjusted to cut by part, by C-type, or by cutting common lines first. You can also do a manual sort same as on the drawing tab. The arrow buttons and dial will allow to move along the sorting order for visualization. And select figures and move them backward, forward, or to the first or last position. On the path option, the path can be inspected to make sure no crossovers occur. A dip path sort allows to create a common line array, consolidating cut paths as possible. At the top right of the section, you can find the simulate button to recreate the movement that the machine will make while executing the nest. Its speed can be adjusted. Below, you can find the auto remnant line feature that allows to set the shape of the remnant lines to cut up the extra material. The shape can be horizontal, vertical, both, offset, and rectangular offset. The remnant line will appear in yellow. This line can also be drawn manually. Additionally, there is also an option to split the remaining sheet skeleton into small parts for easier disposal, same as with the chop command. The program will ask you for the amount of meridian and latitude lines, as well as the gap with parts and minimum cut length threshold to build these lines. There is also an option to move around cut-up lines and even drawing cut-up lines manually. While nesting, you can also modify a number of technical parameters, which are also present on the drawing tab. On the main screen, you can modify those features for all or selected parts, instead of for one particular part. The lead technique will be applied to all parts by default, unless a particular part or parts are selected. Apply all will apply the lead technique to all parts on the nest. Next to lead is the delete function, which will now allow to delete all of selected features per type. The delete position can now be applied both to any particular part or to all of one part kind. The remaining commands work the same way as on the drawing screen. On the Tools tab, you'll first find the measure button again. The layer parameters for the metal thickness and type can be manually loaded from a .fsm file. In case your laser cutter comes equipped with an inkjet printer laser head extension, a printer label can be added to each part for the nest with the Add Tag button. The label orientation can be selected, as well as the minimum gap to part contours. Multiple templates for labels can be created. Labels are composed by lines which can be filled with simple text and even QR and bar codes. Dynamic text will be filled with predefined content, such as the part name variable, while fixed text will be filled with custom text content. The font, size, and alignment can be configured as desired. QR codes can be set to display predefined content as well as custom, while barcodes can only illustrate custom text. The push command allows for a simplified job transfer to one or multiple laser cutters. If the machine is on the same network, it should appear on the list. If not, the IP address of the machine can be typed manually. The job will be sent as a task. The task name can be modified and notes for operators can be sent, such as plate size, thickness, nozzle size, or more. The sticky task checkbox makes it so the task can be deleted unless it's completed, and the split checkbox will split separate plates into separate jobs. The table below will show the different type of nested plates used in the job, with their area, amount of sheets needed, material, estimated process time, and status. The push button will send the task to the machine, which can be then loaded and executed by the operator. Alternatively, the job can be exported manually and loaded to the machine through a network drive or USB thumb drive. One of the best features of ZipNest is its ability to generate complete reports for jobs information as well as quotation. Clicking on the Reports button will generate a price, work, and general reports. The price report will automatically calculate process cost based on unitary values that you can modify based on your measured unitary cost. The density, material price per weight, pierce price, cut price per length, and sheet price can be modified to accommodate the cost performance of your operation. The general report will give you an illustration of each different nested sheet with all its information, as well as a parts list of the parts contained within the sheet. The work report is ideal for sharing with operators to help them understand the job in question. It includes a first page where all different plates and parts are laid out with all its information on quantity, time, and size, as well as a general report showed earlier with information of each one of the sheets being processed. The report and client name can be modified on the top left. At the right, you can access the Set General Report Params tab and change parameters such as the export path for the report that can be automatically set to portray one or many process variables, as well as the price unit, unitary cost parameters, header and footer text, etc. Each one of the reports can be printed or exported to PDF separately. The task info is determined by parameter set on the initialization screen. Templates can be exported and imported between instances of ZipNest. The report can also be exported as an Excel document with all the information from the three report types. A help tab is available in case you would like to repeat tutorials, contact support, or read the guide. The user settings button will allow to modify a couple of settings such as the paint board visual settings, expert settings, snapping and toolpath settings, and other settings which will include the auto backup function. Additional to the options on the main top tab, below you will have a command log of all the commands executed, as well as align and rotate command for parts within the drawing area. The drawing area itself will have a ruler for scale reference, as well as coordinate indicators for the mouse pointer. On the top bar, you'll have your new file button that will close your current file and open a blank new one. You can also load previously saved files, save or save as your current file, undo or redo, and also access to the settings and help options from before.